Hello students, I am Vinita from Government Polytechnic, Bagyapalli. So today I am going to explain the concept feedback in amplifiers. So the contents are the concept of feedback, types of feedback, comparison between types of feedback, review questions and multiple choice questions. The first topic is concept of feedback. Before going to the concept of feedback, just we memorize the basic information regarding amplifier and its types. So what is amplifier? So amplifier is an electronic circuit. It gives the amplified version of the input signal. That is, the output of the amplifier is increase the strength of the input signal without any change in the shape of the input signal. That is called, we will call it as a faithful amplification. So here in this, the amplifier circuit, that is VI, R, VS, R, VIN. So in the different books, they will give the different notations for the input signal. So we can use any one of the notation here for the input voltage. Similarly for the output also, V0 or Vout notations, any one we can take. And A is the voltage gain of the amplifier. So here the amplifier, we are using the amplifier. It is used to increase the strength of the input signal without change any shape of the signal. That is, we can say output of any amplifier, it should exact replica of the input signal. Now we say the classifications. Depending upon the frequency, we can say audio amplifier, radio amplifier and video amplifiers. And based on the signals, small signal amplifiers, that is, we can say voltage amplifier and current amplifier, and large signal amplifiers. Large signal amplifiers means we can say power amplifiers. And depending upon the coupling, we can classify RC coupling, transformer coupling and direct coupling amplifiers. And next, for the amplifier circuit, we are using the transistor, that is BJT, we are using the basic part. So the transistor, depending upon this configuration also, we can classify the amplifiers, common base, common collector and common emitter. So among these three types, the common emitter is the most commonly used CE amplifier. Why? We are choosing the common emitter only, means in this, the characteristics of the common emitter amplifier is it gives high power gain and moderate voltage gain and current gains, and also medium input resistance and output resistance. So because of these characteristics of the CE amplifier will meet our requirement of the day-to-day applications in the fields communication, that is radio communication or satellite communication, and instrumentation, and also medical electronic field. So therefore, most commonly used amplifier type is CE amplifier. So here what happens, CE amplifier, here we are considering CE amplifier only. It's a CE amplifier, and one of the important point regarding this CE amplifier is output signal, we get 180 degree phase shift of the input signal. So as shown in the figure, you observe there, for the amplifier circuit, we are giving the sinusoidal voltage and the output we are getting amplified version of the input signal, but here 180 degree phase shift, right? So next is, an ideal linear amplifier provides an output that is an exact replica of the input signal, right? So the faithful amplification means exact replica of the input signal only. So but due to some reasons, that is practical amplifiers, it will produce the distorted output. So due to a non-linearity of the transistor characteristics, parameter variations, that is parameter variation means the for the transistors, the different parameters, that is current gain beta, and also a input base voltage, that is VBE, supply voltage and all, and temperature effects. So due to these effects, what happens? The output of the practical amplifier, it not the exact replica of the input signal. That is, some shape will be changes. That is, any abrupt changes in the output signal. So, in order to get the exact replica, we have to minimize these effects. How we can going to minimize these effects? So, using some principle, that principle we will call it as a feedback. If you are using the feedback concept, we can minimize the effects that is due to a non-linearity characteristics or parameter variations or temperature effects. So, the feedback, concept of feedback. The actual topic is concept of feedback. Now, what is feedback? The fractional amount of output is fed back to the input is called as feedback. That is, here the output signal V naught, the fraction of this output signal, again we fed back to the input side. So, that is called as feedback. So, using this concept in the amplifiers, we will call it as those amplifiers called as feedback amplifiers. That is amplifiers which use the feedback principle are called feedback amplifiers. A feedback amplifier consists of two parts, namely amplifier circuit and feedback network. That is, output is sampled and returned to the input through the feedback network. So, here you observe in this block diagram here, the output of fraction output of the amplifier circuit is fed back to the input through feedback network. That is, the fraction of signal is fed back to the input through some media we required. That is, that media we will call it as a feedback network. So, in this, the overall system now, amplifier with feedback, we'll get the two parts. The one is amplifier and second one is feedback network. So, it got two parts. You remember amplifier part and feedback part, that is feedback network. So, therefore, in the input side, we have two signals. That is, first signal is input signal Vin and second signal is part of the output which is feedback to the input. That is called feedback signal, we can say VF. So, here there are two parts, amplifier part and feedback network. And also for the input side, there are two signals. One signal is the input signal and second signal is the feedback signal, comes from the feedback network. Next, depending upon the weather, the feedback signal opposes or adds the input signal. We can say that is opposes or add means the fraction of output signal is fed back to the input. That feedback signal, what happens? That is, it adds to the input signal or it opposes the input signal. Depending upon that, we can say there are two types. First, negative feedback or degenerative feedback. Second one is positive feedback or regenerative feedback. So, first we consider that is negative feedback or degenerative feedback. So, here you see the block diagram here. In this block diagram, the upper portion is the amplifier part and lower portion is the feedback network. That is, the sinusoidal input signal is applying to the input for the amplifier and we get the 180 degree phase shift of the input signal we are getting as a output. But that is amplified version. Because here amplifier is, we are considering CE amplifier, or we can say that is inverting amplifier. So, therefore, the output is 180 degree phase shift with the input signal, right? And also, the shape of the signal is doesn't change here. Then, the fraction of the output signal is given as input for the feedback network. Now, for the feedback network, the input signal is the fraction of the output signal. And next, the output of the feedback signal, we tell us VF, that is feedback signal. You observe here, that is the feedback signal is, again it adds or opposes with the input signal and it is fed back to the input for the amplifier there. So, depending upon the phase shift, we can say it adds or subtracts. So, in the negative feedback, what happens? When input signal V in and part of output signal VF are out of phase, such a feedback is called as negative feedback. You observe here, the feedback signal is 180 degree phase shift with the input signal. So here the sinusoidal signal is applying to the amplifier and we get the 180 degree phase shift because amplifier is the CE amplifier and the fraction of that signal is fed back to the input through the feedback network. So input for the feedback network is now fraction of the output signal. So that is why anyway 180 degree phase shift. So therefore the feedback network function is, it just introduces the 0 degree phase shift. So therefore the feedback signal VF that is shown in the figure and that is opposes the phase shift of the input signal. So therefore here the difference of the signal, now what we will get, that signal is applied to the input for the amplifier circuit here. That is only, that is input signal and phase feedback signal is 180 degree phase shift or out of phase, we'll say out of phase. So next, the feedback signal VF is subtracts with the degenerative with the input signal. So therefore what happens here, the difference of the signal we are applying to the input for the amplifier because signals are input signal and feedback signals are out of phase here. So next point, negative feedback reduces the gain of the amplifier. Therefore, the negative feedback is called degenerative feedback. So here, you observe here, the input signal and feedback signal is out of phase. So therefore, what happens? The difference of the signal is now applied to the input for the amplifier. So that gets reduced. So therefore, input voltage is reduces. So if the input voltage is reduces, what happens to the output? The output is also reduces. So output is reduces, what about the gain? This is the ratio of the output voltage of the amplifier with the input voltage of the amplifier. So what happens? V naught by V in. Now input is reducing, output is also reducing. So what about the gain? The gain is also reducing. So therefore here, negative feedback, it reduces the gain of an amplifier. So therefore it is called negative feedback and is called also called as degenerative feedback, right? So next, voltage gain AF, you observe here AF. So AF is the gain of the feedback amplifier, right? A is the gain of the amplifier without feedback and AF is the gain of the amplifier with feedback, right? AF. So it is found to be very stable because it depends only upon the feedback ratio beta. That is, feedback ratio will given as, that is the ratio of the feedback voltage VF to output voltage V naught. See here the feedback network, that factor will take, it is the ratio of the output by input of the feedback network. The feedback network output is, you see the, observe the arrow, the output is VF and input of the feedback network is V naught. So the ratio of the VF by V naught is, we will say, that is the feedback factor. So the gain of the entire amplifier, feedback amplifier, that is the considering the both the portions, upper portion, that is the amplifier portion, and also the lower portion, that is the feedback network portion. So considering these two, the gain, what will get the gain, that is AF, gain of the amplifier with feedback, that is depending upon the feedback network factor, right? So therefore, it is the gain, voltage gain AF is found to be very stable because it depends only upon the feedback ratio. So why it is maintained constant, that is a stable, means feedback ratio beta, that is VF by V naught is not affected by any change in device parameters, right? So that is supply voltage are from aging of the circuit components. That is what is the meaning of this means. The feedback factor, it is not depends on the device parameters, that such as VBE or current gain, that is IC by IB. So it is not depends upon that, and also supply voltage, and also from aging of circuit components. aging of circuit components means, that is the old components, we can say old components, it is not depending upon that. So therefore, what happens, the beta factor, the feedback factor, it doesn't affect. So we can say AF for this block diagram, that is the gain of the feedback here. So what happens, gain of the feedback, it is depending upon the amplifier gain and also the feedback factor beta. So here, due to the circuit parameters, our circuit of supply voltage and all, beta doesn't depends. So that is the feedback factor, it doesn't depends. So there is no changes in that. With feedback, there is no change. So therefore, what happens, the overall system gain AF is depending upon the both A and beta. So A is changes due to a circuit parameters or supply voltage or aging of the components. But beta is does not affect, doesn't change. So whatever the changes in the amplifier gain A, it doesn't make difference of the with the AF. Andre amplifier gain A change agutte depending upon the circuit components, but beta depend agalla. So what happens, the entire system feedback will does not change that much, andre jaasti changes agadilla AF. So enagutte, that maintains some constant there. So how it will maintain constant, how we can say feedback elements or does not affect, means the stability of the voltage gain AF is achievable only if the feedback network is made up of stable elements such as resistors, inductors and capacitors. See here, so for the feedback network, that is the important point to be note here, we should choose the feedback network is a stable elements, consists of a stable elements. So that is resistors, inductors and capacitor. The most commonly used is resistors only for the feedback network. That is these resistors or these capacitors and all does not affected by any change in the device parameters, supply voltage or from aging of the circuit components. So due to this, what happens, the gain of your amplifier with feedback will does not changes, right? So that is the amplifier of the gain will changes here, the amplifier of the gain, amplifier gain will changes, but feedback factor beta is does not change, right? So overall system gain is depending upon the amplifier gain and the beta. So therefore, any changes occurs, adu eno system gain mele affect madadilla. So small variations will occur. So we can say that is a constant gain. It's maintained with feedback. So that is, we can say that is stable gain. So what are the advantages of the negative feedback? So first one is better stabilized voltage gain. So better stabilized voltage gain means here what happens, better stabilized means here we know that the voltage gain of the entire system is does not changes more, that is jaasti change agala gain. So because a feedback network is, we are choosing the passive elements, that is resistor, capacitor or inductor. So if you use the feedback network in the active elements, what happens? Again, if you are using the active elements in the feedback network, what happens, these active elements such as a diode or transistor, if you are using here, what happens, again the beta is also changes depending upon the temperature, it will affect, and also any parameters changes, that is also affect. So there is no use of the feedback concept there. So therefore, in the feedback network, we should choose or we select the stable elements, that is passive elements, resistors or capacitors. So most commonly used is resistors. So these are not depending upon the any variations in the changes in the amplifier parameters. So therefore, entire system gain is maintained. So we can say that is called as stable gain. So therefore, the advantage of the negative feedback is stabilized voltage gain, right? So second one is increased bandwidth. So what is bandwidth? Bandwidth means the usable range of gain right? Usable frequency range. So in that frequency range, what happens? The gain should be maintained constant, right? If you changes the gain, what happens to the signal? Suppose, for example, we are watching the TV. So TV, we are watching the TV, in that audio signal is also there. So what happens if the gain is varies for the range of frequency what we are watching there, right? So gain is rising means volume is also get disrupted, right? So now kelsod yen aagthirutte iddakiddange high aagthirutte signal iddakiddange low aagthirutte. So what happens, it is not suitable, right? Comfortable aagiradilla namge kelsikolodakke. So on that time what we need, the stabilized voltage gain ittu andre namak signal lo constant aagi volume alli kelustha irutte. So the range of frequency, that is whatever the range, in that range the gain should be constant. So anyway, in the negative feedback, better stabilized voltage gain we are getting. So the therefore bandwidth is also increases there. So next is more linear operation, right? So yake antandre, why the linear operation here? The gain of the overall system, right? Gain of the overall system depends on both the factors, that is the A, amplifier gain, and beta, that is the feedback network factor. ಸೊ ಅವೆರಡರ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಭಾಳ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಅಕ್ಕರ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಮೋರ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟಾರ್ಷನ್, ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟಾರ್ಷನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಪ್ಲಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನಿಕ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಾರ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟಾರ್ಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟಾರ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ದ amplifiers, right? So next is reduced noise is also less, and input and output characteristics can be modified as desired. Means whatever the input and output resistance we required, we can modify to our requirements by using this negative feedback. Due to these advantages of the negative feedback, and also the most commonly is, that is the most important is, better stabilized voltage gain and also distortion is less. These two factors is the our requirement for the any amplifier in order to get the faithful amplification, that is output signal is exact replica of the input signal. These requirement we need. So therefore in amplifiers the most commonly used feedback is negative feedback, right? So why the negative feedback is employed in the amplifiers means the amplifier requirement is most requirement is one is the reduced distortion, right? In many applications, suppose for example we are using the amplifier in the microphone, means in that pre as a pre amplifier we need the less distorted signal we need. So the our requirement is less distorted signal and also a more stable gain we required, right? So these two requirements will meet using the negative feedback in amplifiers. So therefore negative feedback is employed in the amplifiers, right? Next topic is positive feedback. Next type of the feedback is positive feedback or regenerative feedback. So here positive feedback, you observe the feedback block diagram, the upper portion again the amplifier, lower portion is feedback network, right? Upper portion is amplifier and lower portion is the feedback network. So again here the input voltage Vin is sinusoidal input applying to the amplifier circuit. And the output is we are getting 180 degree phase shift, right? That is the amplifier is CE amplifier, or we can say inverting amplifier. So therefore 180 degree phase shift with the input signal, but we are getting the faithful amplified signal there. The shape of the signal is not changes. And the output, the fraction of the output signal is fed back to the feedback network. That is the fraction of the output signal is acts as the input for the feedback signal. And feedback signal VF is the output of the feedback network, right? So here you observe input signal VI and output signal of the feedback network is VF are in phase in such a that we can say feedback is called as positive feedback. That is the both the signals are in phase, right? In the negative amplifier, what happens? The both the signals are out of phase. So here both the signals VI and the VF are in phase, right? An inverting amplifier produces a phase shift of 180 degree. A further phase shift of 180 degree is introduced by feedback network. Consequently, the signal is shifted by 360 degree and fed to the input. That is, feedback voltage is in phase with the input signal. That is, amplifier here using CE amplifier. We can say that is inverting amplifier because output signal is 180 degree phase shift with the input signal. So, therefore, that is the inverting amplifier. So, that amplifier portion, it introduces the 180 degree phase shift there. And then fraction of the output signal is fed back to the input for the feedback signal, right? Feedback network. So, what happens? What is the job of the feedback network here? It also introduces one more 180 degree phase shift, right? Then total phase shift, what happens? 180 plus 180, 360 degree. Or we can say 360 degree or 0 degree we can say. So, therefore, the feedback signal is in phase with the input signal. So, this is called as positive feedback. And the positive signal, feedback signal, VF, will add to or regenerate the input signal. Here, both the signals VI and the VF are in phase. So, therefore, what happens? In phase means add together, right? It will add or we can say regenerate. Means increase, regenerate, increase, right? So, therefore, it adds the VI signal and VF signal, right? So, next is positive feedback. It increases the distortion, noise and instability. Because of these disadvantages, positive feedback is not employed in amplifiers. That is how the distortion and noise instability we'll see here in this block diagram. What happens? Input signal and the feedback signal, both the signals are, what happens, both the signals, that is in phase. In phase means add together. Add means increases. So what happens to the input here? Input of the amplifier is increases. If the input of the amplifier is increases, we'll get the output is also increases. So, we know that the gain, what is the gain? That is the ratio of the output of and input. That is, the output of the amplifier circuit is increases and input of the amplifier is also increases. The gain is increases. So, the gain is increases here. So, therefore, what happens here? The stability is decreases. The input again is increasing, so therefore instability we can say, right? So due to some these factor is also we can say the distortion is also increases. So therefore we are not going to use this positive feedback in the amplifiers, but we can use the positive feedback in the oscillator circuit because for the oscillator we need a continuous oscillations. So therefore prefer the positive feedback in oscillators, right? So, these are the positive feedback and negative feedback. Now, we'll discuss the comparison between the negative and positive feedback. So, what is the comparison? So, first we consider the parameters there, right? So, parameters means the phase shift between input signal and phase feedback signal. So, what happens to the in negative feedback, that is 180 degree, right? That is out of phase. The both the feedback signal and the input signal are out of phase. So, therefore, it introduces the 180 degree phase shift between the feedback signal and the input signal. But in the positive feedback, that is the feedback signal and input signal are in phase. So, therefore, it is a 0 degree or 360 degree. So, what about the input voltage? So, for the input voltage is decreases in the negative feedback because feedback signal and input signal are out of phase. So, therefore, we'll get the difference of the signal applying to the amplifier, right? So therefore input voltage is decreases. Input voltage is decreases, what about the output voltage? So output voltage is also decreases. So therefore gain, voltage gain of the amplifier is also decreases, because voltage gain is the ratio of the output voltage by input voltage. So therefore that is also decreases. And you come to the positive feedback, what about the input voltage? So in both the signals, that is a feedback signal and input signal, are in phase, in phase. So therefore the input voltage is increases. Input voltage is increases means output voltage is also increases. So what about the gain? Gain is also increases there, right? So next, sixth one, the distortion. What about the distortion in the negative feedback is decreases. So how the distortion is decreases in the negative feedback, right? We'll see here, this is the block diagram of the negative feedback. So we'll say distortion, D is the distortion of the amplifier part, that is the upper portion part, D, right? And next, overall system distortion will take DF, that is distortion with feedback, right? So due to the parameters changes are temperature and other characteristics, the whatever the distortion of the amplifier will increases, right? But overall distortion is depending upon here the amplifier and the feedback network. That is, feedback factor is the independent of those changes. So therefore the distortion is occurs very small. So this is the fraction of the distorted signal is fed back to the input there. The input signal is little bit decreases there. So what happens to the overall distortion? It get reduces, right? So whatever the changes will doesn't make difference with the overall distortion, right? So therefore distortion with feedback, in the negative feedback what happens, it is decreases, but in positive feedback the distortion is get increases. So distortion in the positive feedback is increases there. And what about the stability? Stability is, we know that the negative feedback, if you are using the stable gain we've obtained, that is almost all stable means almost all constant voltage gain. So therefore stability is increases using the negative feedback, and the stability is decreases using the positive feedback. So what about the application? Application, you come to the application, negative feedback is used in the amplifier. So because it meets the whatever the requirements of our, right? The whatever the requirements we required, that is the stable gain and a reduced distortion we get. So therefore this amplifier we get the, so these two, that is a stable gain and reduced distortion, will meet our requirement of the amplifier. So therefore the negative feedback is employed in the amplifiers, right? So our next, positive feedback is employed in the oscillators. So therefore wherever we'll use these amplifiers and oscillators, those are all application fields. Suppose for example in our lab, we are using the function generator and CRO, signal generator and all. So in that also the some amplifiers are used and oscillators also used. And home appliances, we can say television, in the television also amplifiers also used and oscillators also used. So the in communication, we can say generally, we can say in communication field, satellite communication, radio communication, right? And next is instrumentation. And medical field, the medical field, electronics, and also we are using these feedback concepts, that is positive feedback or negative feedback concepts, right? So review questions, what are the review questions? The these are the assessment for the students. These questions, define feedback and mention its type. So just we summarize now, right? Points, feedback means the fraction of the output signal is fed back to the input is called as feedback, and its types are positive feedback and negative feedback. Next, define negative feedback and mention its advantages. Negative feedback means, you remember this point, negative means minus, positive means plus. So negative means minus means what happens here? The feedback signal and the input signal both are out of phase. So out of phase signals we are here. So that feedback we will call it as a negative feedback. And what are these advantages? Better stabilized voltage gain, bandwidth is increases, and input resistance and output resistance we can modify to our requirements, and distortion is reduced, and frequency, amplitude, harmonic, and these distortions will reduce us. So noise is also less. These are the major advantages. And next, third question, list out the differences between negative feedback and positive feedback. So you recall this table, we can say the difference between the positive feedback and negative feedback. And next, explain why do we prefer negative feedback. So why we are using the negative feedback only in amplifiers? Because if we are using the negative feedback in the amplifiers, it will meet our requirements, whatever the amplifier requirement, that is stabilized voltage gain and reduced distortion. These two mainly will get using this negative feedback. So therefore, we prefer the negative feedback in amplifiers. So next is, list out the applications. Applications, general we can say, that is in communication, instrumentation, medical electronic field and all, etc. And particularly we can say that is our lab appliances, you know that is the function generators, CRO, signal generators, and the home appliances like television and all. So we can use this feedback applications. And next, illustrate the negative feedback with relevant figure. So for this question, we have to explain the block diagram of the negative feedback. So with the negative feedback block diagram, you have to explain this here. The signal feedback signal is out of phase with the input signal, right? And we should choose the feedback network is the stable elements, right? Passive elements. So on that time, how the distortion is reduces using this feedback network, and also how the signal, that is the voltage gain, is maintained constant. You have to explain these things regarding with the block diagram. And next is multiple choice questions. So multiple choice questions. First question, stabilized voltage gain is obtained from dash feedback in amplifier. Again, here in the positive feedback, we won't get the voltage gain constant. So in the using negative feedback only, we are getting the voltage gain constant, that is stable gain. So therefore, the answer is B, negative feedback. If you are using the negative feedback in the amplifier, we'll get the stabilized voltage gain. Next question. Negative feedback is employed in dash, right? So in rectifiers, we are not dealing with any feedback in that, right? Not much. So in the oscillators, we need continuous oscillations. If you are using the negative feedback, means what happens? Input signal is decreases. If input signal is decreases, output is also decreases there. So therefore, the gain is also reducing there. So, right? Right, oscillators, what happens there? Input voltage increases, output voltage also increases, right? So the gain is also increases there. But the negative feedback, what happens? It decreases the input voltage and the gain is also decreases. So we are not using in the oscillator also. So therefore, negative feedback is employed in amplifiers, right? The next question. When negative voltage feedback is applied to an amplifier, its voltage gain. So what about the voltage gain here? Increased or decreased? If you are using the negative voltage there, input is decreasing and output is also decreasing. So therefore, the ratio of output by input is voltage gain. It get, what about this? It is decreasing. So therefore, if you are employing the negative feedback in the amplifier, the voltage gain is reduced. So next question is, when a negative voltage feedback is applied to an amplifier, its bandwidth. So what happens to the bandwidth if you are using the negative feedback? So and the bandwidth means it is the usable range of frequency. In that range, our gain should be maintained constant. That is called, we'll call it as a bandwidth. So therefore, in which feedback is maintains the gain, we know that the negative feedback, the voltage gain is stable, right? So therefore, what about the bandwidth is increased. So next question, when input signal and part of output signal are out of phase, right, are out of phase, the feedback is called dash. So input signal and feedback signal are out of phase, in which feedback? In positive feedback is in phase, so negative feedback is out of phase, right? So the option is B, the answer is B. These are the team members prepared the e-content for analog electronic circuit.